Hi, I'm Benila. In this video, I'm going to talk about the connection schemes of the electrical distribution system. The distribution system mainly consists of feeders and distributors. A feeder is a conductor which connects the substation to the area where the power is to be distributed. Generally, no tappings are taken from the feeder so that the current in it remains the same throughout. A distributor is a conductor from which tappings are taken for supply to consumers. So basically, the distribution system is the connection of these feeders, distributors and substation. In general, there are three main connection systems: the radial system, ring main system and interconnected system. Let's first start with the radial system. Here, separate feeders radiate from a single substation and feed the distributors at one end only. This is the simplest and cheapest network for an electrical grid. This radial system is employed only when the power is generated at very low voltage and the substation is located at the center of the load. This serves light and medium density load areas. This system has some drawbacks. If you look carefully, you can understand that the distributor is fed at one end only. This end of the distributor nearest to the feeding point will be heavily loaded, and the consumers at the distant end of the distributor would be subjected to serious fluctuations when the load on the distributor changes. Since the consumers are dependent on a single feeder and single distributor, any fault on the feeder or distributor cuts off supply to the consumers connected to the distributor. In other words, the consumers in this radial electrical distribution system would be in darkness until the feeder or the transformer was rectified. Due to these limitations, the radial system is used only for short distance. The drawbacks of the system can be overcome by introducing a ring main system. In this system, the primaries of the distribution transformers form a loop. The loop circuit starts from the substation bus bar, makes a loop through the area to be served, and returns to the substation. Here, the substation supplies a closed feeder. The distributors are tapped from different points of the feeder. This system is very reliable as each distributor is fed through two feeders. As an alternative path is available, in the event of a fault with any section of the feeder, the continuity of the supply is maintained. Another advantage of this system is that there are fewer voltage fluctuations at the consumer's terminal. Of course, this system is more complicated and expensive than the radial system. Now, let's move on to our next system, interconnected system. Here, the feeder ring is energized by two or more generating stations or substations. This increases service reliability. Any area fed from one generating system during peak load hours can be fed from the other generating station. This increases the efficiency of the system. If you are interested in learning about the peak load and base load power plants, I do have a video about it. I'm sure you'll find it useful. Bye, see you in my next video.